Started to re-rip open like that wound again. So the Xbox Series X release date is going to be November 10th. Mark your calendars. And the PlayStation 5 release date will be November 12th, so 2 days after.
What I'm hoping for is, since I work at Walmart...
I was going to say that earlier. Just do that.
Like, I know it's going to... When it comes in. But when the 1X came out, I had it pre-ordered at Walmart. They're not letting us pre-order this Xbox at Walmart. I don't know why.
Yeah.
But when I pre-ordered the 1X, it didn't even get there on the release date. It came like a week later, so I canceled my pre-order, went to GameStop, got it, came back, and had a fight with them for like an hour to get my money back. And
that's super frustrating. What the hell? There was going to be extra units at launch, by the way. Associates. Sony and Microsoft have gone on record to say there will be extra units at launch. However, whether you want to camp out at nighttime, you know, if you live in a small city, good for you, or a small town. Because maybe it might be even more difficult. It's a smaller community. They might have less units. I always think of like New York and California. They're always going to have a lot of trouble, those big cities, because there's a lot more people, right? So.
Yeah, I'll be just waiting for the second one, I think.
I do not blame you at all. I don't blame you at all. There's no reason to. There's nothing. I mean, if it was Halo Infinite, it'd be a different story, right? So.
Oh, my God.
Absolutely.
Sorry to re-rip open like that wound again.
It was supposed to come out next month.
Yeah, Chase sent me this. He was that upset. He actually did cut off one of his fingers because he was that mad. I'm just kidding. It was just like a little Resident Evil USB, just so no one thinks there's like a morbid dead finger on my desk.
It would actually be my toe, probably.
I was going to say, because you always say the toe meme, but I didn't have a toe readily available. Well, just a zombified
God,
one.
God, that hurts so bad.
What do you guys think about Microsoft buying ZeniMax and Bethesda?
Oof, spicy.
Pretty crazy, right?
That's a very spicy subject. I mean, I could talk about that, but I want to let one of you speak first. Oof. Oof.
Yeah, I just think, I don't know. My biggest question is, do those A1 titles that we've all been, you know, the Elder Scrolls games, Fallout, do these games now become exclusive titles for Xbox going forward? I know Phil Spencer said whatever is supposed to come out on PlayStation as of now, what's already in the works is not going to change. It's not going to now all of a sudden become a Microsoft exclusive or Xbox exclusive, but going forward, he didn't clarify. So obviously, if you're a fan of Elder Scrolls, which there's tons of us, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Even if you're not a fan, you've probably bought and played Skyrim or any of the Fallout games at some point in time. Very popular games. You know, are those going to be exclusive titles going forward? I think that's the biggest question. You know, how much they spent to buy all those studios, I couldn't tell you whether that's a good deal or a bad deal. That's kind of out of my lane. All just seems like funny money after you get into the billions range.
Yeah. What was the purchase amount? We're going to have it up on screen. It was some like asinine, like 2-point-something billion, probably even more than that.
7.5.
Jesus Christ. $7.5 billion with a B. Yeah. Tres comas. So,
how much sales tax would go into that?
Oh, I have no idea. I don't even know. Like, I don't even want to think. It'll make my brain break. I'm sure the accountants are having a field day with that. Transfer of power.
But it's done, so I just kind of wonder, you know, those A1 titles, who gets them, what kind of happens with that, and not much more other than that, but I am interested, you know, to see what happens in the future.
I can actually take the torch on this one, if that's cool, Chase, once you wanted to get a little jab in there real quick. Yeah, go ahead.
My thought is, how much different of sales do you think Xbox and PlayStation get from Bethesda games? Do you think they're pretty much even, or do you think there's more one way or the other?
Without looking at the metrics, I'd say it's probably going to be swinging a little bit more towards the Xbox side, and here's my reasoning behind that. As we've seen through the years, more recently, within, I'd say, if we're giving a time frame on it, the last decade, PlayStation has had more exclusive titles. So with what comes with that is more games that people would purchase a console for. With that being said, on Xbox, there's still a lot of really good titles and a lot of third-party games, you know, which obviously come out on all platforms for the most part, at least all the next generation. I'm not trying to bash on Switch because they have gotten a couple that have even been like, whoa, that came out for Switch. Witcher 3, I'm looking at you. But I will say that Xbox players that are loyal, which I have met a lot of them, and I used to be one myself. I'm not that anymore. They will just look for games to play, and if it's a AAA killer app like Skyrim, they're absolutely going to buy it. I think it got re-released for the Xbox One yet again. That game's been released so many times. That's like a meme in itself. Same with, like, you know, Tony talked about Fallout and Skyrim. We're forgetting about Doom, which is a smash hit as well. I mean, ever since the reboot and back in 2016, the game is kind of more...
such a fun game, too.
It absolutely was. It kind of goes back to the arena style, super, super quick, you know, satisfaction. I really thought it wouldn't have its place because Call of Duty has kind of taken that's thrown. It's like the modern day Doom, if you think about it, or modern day Quake. However, people love it, and I think it's playing on the nostalgia, but it's actually a genuinely good game. And I haven't played Doom Eternal. I still have it. Shame on me, I know. You can see the helmet behind me, probably.
It's pretty fun.
Probably not.
Played it for like a day.
Solid.
Yeah, but I will get to it eventually. Doom games are fantastic. And then another lesser known was the Dishonored games. I know they came out with Dishonored 1 and 2. I want to say there's one more. Oh, yeah, Wolfenstein. That's another big one, too. Wolfenstein was absolutely huge. That's by it as well.
Tons. Yeah.
I went off on that tangent. I forgot the question. What was it again? What else did you ask? That's what happens. Boomer hours.
Something about sales swinging one way or the other.
Oh, so I think I answered that. So, yeah, with sales swinging one way or the other, I think Xbox would definitely have more sales. I mean, we're forgetting about PC players, which, you know, there's going to be a ton of sales in there, too. But I think it's going to sway more towards Xbox and Microsoft, more specifically. Hey guys, this is Animus Divide in post-production. So I did look up the metrics. It looks like, in fact, the PlayStation 4 did sell more units of Skyrim in contrast to the Xbox One. This article was from 2016. However, it's worth mentioning that I want to make sure I give you guys the right information. I don't want to ever spread misinformation. I think personally, the reasoning for that is because the PlayStation 4 did sell more units than the Xbox One. So it would make a lot more sense to me fundamentally that the PlayStation 4 version would have sold more than the Xbox, because there are a lot more PlayStation 4s out in the wild. Let's get back into the video. To kind of give my thoughts now on the acquisition, that was a big power play by Microsoft, and I don't blame them, just because Sony has shown, again, I spoke about it a little bit earlier, that they have good exclusive games, and they have a lot of them. Like, it's not just they're just pumping out games just to pump out. Like, these are good games. A lot of them have been, they've kind of fallen into that ship of third person, which I'm okay with, because I subjectively love those. But they're just good games. They have good story. They have good animation. They have good graphics. They have good developers behind them, too. So I think Microsoft, instead of just making these good IPs with the developers they already have, or making some new ones, or even reimagining like God of War did, you know, where we went from God of War 3 to the new reboot, which was fantastic. It was probably even better, and that's even tough for me to say because I love God of War. I love the OGs. I think they're kind of buying their way into exclusivity. Exclusivity? Yeah, there you go. I think that's the word.
There you go.
So it's definitely power play. I will say, if I'm being quite honest, Skyrim, we keep saying Skyrim because that's kind of like the Baby Yoda of the Elder Scrolls. It's actually Elder Scrolls. Elder Scrolls has kind of lost a little bit of gas. I'm not going to lie to you. Skyrim came out and it was good, it was amazing. I'm sorry, it was definitely a killer app. It's been released multiple times. If you haven't seen it even on your fridge, then you're probably living under a rock. And then if we think about Elder Scrolls Online, which was poised to be Skyrim but multiplayer, it was a flash in the pan. It was super popular. It kind of trailed off. It still has its loyal fan base, but it's more of a niche game. Doom has been picking up some momentum, so I'll give credit there. But however, that's not, I hate to even say this, there's probably people watching this that are thinking like, don't you dare talk bad about Doom. And I'm not talking bad about it. I'll just say that it's a big game, and it's a huge game, and it's a popular game, but it doesn't compare to Fallout, my personal opinion, or Skyrim for the time being. That could change. I think that Doom has been performing very, very well lately. Doom Eternal, I think, is better than Elder Scrolls. I know it's apples and oranges, but if we're talking on sales metrics, I'm sure that I could look that up and see that. Now, Fallout, that's another one that's lost a lot of gas, too. So we think about from Fallout 4, which was, it was a little bit mixed, but it was still really, really, really good from a lot of people, from what I heard. But from Fallout 3, which was the apex, the height of Fallout, then moving on to Fallout New Vegas, Fallout 76, which was supposed to be Fallout, but multiplayer, kind of what Skyrim, right? Skyrim multiplayer. That game had bugs galore. There was no NPCs. It felt very, very bland and empty. It felt like this was like a beta test. And I can tell you, I really tried to put in the time and effort and play it. It wasn't necessarily a bad game. I know they've released a lot of updates. Game. Yeah, it didn't feel like Fallout, though. It just felt very, very hollow, which is kind of sad coming from Bethesda. So with Microsoft purchasing it, you have to figure, guys, for that, Tony said $7.5 billion. They had to have sent some Microsoft guys over there. They had to look at the, you know, down the pipeline, like what's coming out, what are they working on? They're not going to just come in and buy that, that big name of a developer without having something. Obviously, we got a little bit of a baby micro teaser for the new Elder Scrolls game. You guys see the Elder Scrolls 6? People were calling Elventide or Eventide. I can't remember. Anyways, I'm really, 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 really pumped about that. So I'm hoping that's going to be amazing. We'll probably won't see that till 2023, 2022. And then Fallout. Yeah. Sorry, real quick. Fallout, I think what's going to end up happening with that is they're hopefully going to go back to the basics. I'd even be okay with if they went back to the Fallout 3 formula and story and even did like a remastered, maybe like an anniversary of that game. So let me pass the torch because this is what I do. I don't want to talk too much.
Yeah, go ahead. The point you made about, you know, these specific titles like Fallout and Elder Scrolls losing steam, maybe there's something to that. Maybe there's a reason why they targeted ZeniMax, Bethesda, and all the subsidiary game developing studios that we haven't mentioned. I think there's like 20 something. I could be off, but I think it's about that many game studios that are included in this purchase. Maybe there's a reason why they targeted these games that have cult followings, big, large potential fan bases, and they want to revitalize them, get the hype going again back for these games. Kind of get them on track, so to speak. Maybe there is a reason why they targeted it with all the different, I think it's probably the volume, if I had to guess, is just the sheer amount of game studios and different development teams that they were able to get for that price, along with the A1 titles already built in. I think that's why they targeted these companies to buy. And it's exactly, as you said, a power play to finally, if not, they're probably not going to beat Sony in terms of quality exclusive titles, but at least be able to get in the same ballpark, you know, so to speak, for lack of a better term. So we'll see what happens. Again, as I've said, I'm excited about all these games going forward. We're almost to the end of 2020, thank God, for more reasons than one.
Amen, brother.
And I'm looking forward to 2021 and the future of gaming here with next-gen consoles and even PC.
So, yeah. PC2 is going to be dropping soon, guys. I'm just kidding.
PC Series Z.
Do you have anything you wanted to tack onto that, Chase? Scratch my ear real quick.
Nah, that sounded pretty good.
Fair enough. Well, now that old man Animus is done scratching his ear, I'm like talking about myself in the third person. It feels so cringe. I appreciate you guys watching. This is the podcast episode 3, our 10th video now on the In Virtual Life YouTube channel. If you got this far, we appreciate you guys as always. And I hope you all have a fantastic night, day, wherever you're at in the world. Peace out. See ya. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please tap the like button. It helps me out a ton. If you're new to the channel, you can join the In Virtual Life family now by subscribing. By doing this, you'll stay up to date with all the memes, streams, podcasts, and content in general. Last, I just wanted to mention our Discord. It's a central hub for all the craziness and fun. Our community is awesome, and we want you to be a part of it. Check the links below for all socials, and as always, have a fantastic day.